Hello everyone, my name is Kumar Aditya and in this video I will show you how you can simulate MOS transistors used in integrated circuit using LTspice. So for MOS transistors which are used for IC design, there is usually flexibility with respect to bulk connection. So here you have to use NMOS4 and PMOS4 symbol. So if you go to the symbol library of LTspice, you can find out this NMOS4 symbol, right? So here you can see this is a 4 terminal device. You have the gate, you have the source, you have the body, and you have the drain. Similarly, for the P channel, you have PMOS4. See here. So here again, you have gate terminal, you have the source, you have the bulk, you have the drain. So these two you have to use. Now symbol is provided, but unfortunately there is no model files. So for power MOSFET, usually we use this 3 terminal device, right? So this is to simulate P channel MOSFET, power MOSFET. And if you go to the library folder, you can pick different model provided by different manufacturer which you can simulate. If let's say some particular MOSFET model you want to simulate which is not included in the library, you can go to the manufacturer website, you can download and you can include it in the library. But for this 4 terminal device, you don't have any model file, so you have to download it from the supplier website, or you can download it from some author also provide it, or you can download it from different foundries website as well. So let me briefly discuss different kind of model which you can simulate for IC design. So here I will mainly talk about 3 different level of MOSFET model: level 1 model, level 3 model, and BSIM model. So level 1 model are useful for teaching application, right? Because they are very easy to correlate with hand analysis. And level 1 model is based on Shockley model, right? This is based on Shockley model. This is also called as the ideal model, and this is given by this fundamental equation. So here this is our drain current, this is our process transconductance, W effective is the width of the channel, L is the length of the channel, lambda is to simulate the channel length modulation effect, right? And VDS is your drain to source voltage, VGS is gate to source voltage, VT is the threshold voltage. And depending upon the region of operation, you have different equation to define that particular region of operation. Along with these 2 equation, you also have this equation to include the body effect, right? So you have VTO plus gamma, right? Gamma is the bulk threshold parameter, also called as the body effect constant, right? Into phi plus VSV, which is the voltage between source and the body terminal, and phi, right? So this is the equation which you use to see the effect of any biasing between source and body on the threshold voltage. So VTO is the threshold voltage with VSV is equal to 0, and if VSV is not equal to 0, then your threshold voltage deviates from VTO value, and which is given by this equation. So these 2 equation plus this equation you can use to simulate level 1 MOSFET. All you have to do is define this parameter. So in LTspice, KP is recognized as KP, right? Lambda is recognized as lambda. Phi is written as phi. Gamma is written as gamma. So if you define this parameter, you get a level 1 MOSFET model. So here on my screen I have written a syntax. I have written this syntax for level 1 MOSFET model to define the 1 micrometer process. So here I have defined KP as 120 micro, VDU as 0.8, lambda as 0.0, and gamma as 0.5, and phi as 0.7. In addition to this model file, you have to go into the property of this 4 terminal device, and here you can define the length and width and the drain area and so on, the other parameters, right, of the MOSFET, of which are basically the device parameter. So here I have only defined the channel length as 1 micrometer and width as this variable W, because I want to also show you the effect of varying this width on the characteristics of the MOSFET. So just to give you an example how this parameter you can change to simulate the effect of this variation. So all you have to take care to include this model file, and in the parameter section you define whatever details you want, right? So this is good enough to simulate a level 1 MOSFET model. Now here I am plotting VGS. So on the x-axis I have the gate source voltage, and on the y-axis I have the drain current. So I am plotting ID versus VGS characteristic. So I am plotting this for width of 10 micrometer. Let me check. Yes, here I am plotting it for the width of 10 micrometer. So I get this particular curve, and if I change the width, I can plot a series of curve for the different width. So here I am enabling this command, a step command. So I am varying this W from 10 micrometer to 50 micrometer in the step of 10 micrometer. So if I enable this syntax and rerun the simulation, I will get a series of curve like this. So here again it is ID versus VGS, but for different value of channel width, right? So this green is for the 10 micrometer, this blue is for 20, this is for 30, this is for 40, and this is for 50 micrometer, right? Now you can add more details into this. You can also include the parasitic capacitance, and you will get more accuracy, more accurate characteristic. And you can also go into the help section, and if you type, you know, MOSFET, you can get this m.mosfet. And if you go here it gives you the parameters which LTspice recognizes. These parameters you will use to define the MOSFET you are simulating, right? So VDO is the zero bias threshold voltage. So like I said, when your voltage between bulk and source is zero, the threshold voltage is VDO, and this is called the zero bias threshold voltage. Similarly, KP is the transconductance parameter, gamma is the bulk threshold parameter, phi is the surface inversion potential, lambda is your channel length modulation, and so on, right? So all these things I use to define the level 1 MOSFET model. You can keep on adding. You can add the source ohmic resistance, you can add this zero bias body diode junction capacitance. Similarly, you can add zero bias body source junction capacitance. You can keep on adding this parameter to increase the accuracy of your model. But usually this is good enough. This is good enough for verifying your manual calculation, right? So the level 1 model is used for the teaching, because this is easy to correlate with the hand analysis. So in the textbook you always start with the ideal model equation, right, which is this Shockley, which is based on your Shockley model, and you use this as your starting point to design your MOSFET for a particular process. So this is good enough for the initial verification, but if you want more accuracy, you need to use more accurate model. So second one I am gonna show you is level 3 model. So see here, this is level 3 model, and here it defines much more parameter than what we used in the level 1. So here we are also defining zero bias gate source capacitance, zero bias gate drain capacitance, right? We are also defining this capacitance of the gate oxide, right? TOX is the capacitance per unit area of the oxide layer, right? You have VTO, and so you are essentially defining a number of parameters. So here level 1 you can expand it to make it a level 3 model if you have all the parameter on your hand, right? Or simply you can download it from some provider. I also downloaded it from some website. I don't remember the name actually. I downloaded it long time ago, otherwise I would have given the reference. So here, and let me close this. Here I am again in the second plot. I am plotting the ID versus VGS for the level 3. So here I have used the insta name M3. So this M3 includes this model file for the same 1 micrometer process, and this is a level 3 model. So if you here, if you I go into the property here, see the insta name is M3 and the value is N_1 micro. So this is the name of this level 3 model. So this is the plot I get, and here if I overlap this with level 1 model, you see the difference. So green trace is for the level 3, so the green one is for level 3 and blue one is for level 1, and here you have a very large difference between these two characteristic curve, even though they are for the same MOSFET. And this difference is mainly because this level 3 includes more parameter, so includes parasitics, so it gives you more realistic plot than what you get from a level 1 MOSFET model. Now we have also BSIM model, which is basically a Berkeley model, right? And this is a very elaborate model. So here this is BSIM4 model of 50 nanometer process. I couldn't get for 1 micrometer, otherwise I would have downloaded that and I would have compared it with the level 1 and level 3, but unfortunately I was not able to find one on the internet. So here I am showing you for the 50 nanometer MOSFET, and here you see the size of this model file. It is huge compared to this level 3, right? So this gives you a very elaborate model, and now this is widely used in circuit simulation. This is derived from the device physics, but requires enormous number of parameter to fit the behavior of modern transistor. So there are different version of BC model. You have version 1, version 2, version 3 and 4, right? And in LTspice you can simulate BSIM3 and BSIM4 model. So BSIM3 is actually level 49 model, and BSIM4 is level 54 model. So LTspice can simulate BSIM3 and BSIM4, but LTspice does not recognize level 49. It recognizes level 49 as level 8. So all you have to do is, if you have the model file for BSIM3, you go into that model file and change the level 49 with level 8, and BSIM4 is the level 54, and LTspice actually simulates level 54, so you don't have to make any changes here. So what I am trying to say is, if you go into the BSIM file, see here. Here it is mentioned level 54 because this is BSIM 4 model, right? And similarly, if you have BSIM 3 model, there will be mention of 49. So all you have to do is edit this 49 and make it 8, and you can use it in LTspice. So this is the curve I got for using this BSIM 4 model. So in all the three model, I have used the same biasing. These two are for the 1 micrometer process. This is for 50 micrometer process. So I can't really compare this with this, but I can compare level 1 with level 3 MOSFET. I couldn't get the level 1, level 3 and level BSIM model for the same process. Otherwise, I feel that it would have been much better to show you the level of accuracy you can get with increasing level of the model. But again, I guess you can get an idea what I was trying to show you and how you can simulate the MOSFET used in the integrated circuit design. I hope this is useful, and if you have any comment, you can leave that in comment section. Bye bye.